and he led his company to become one of the nation's fastest growing company in sales training company. He's a motivational leader as well as sales trainer. He trained more than 350,000 sales people. And the contents of this book are not being obsessed, not listening to the prospect, not planning the day efficiently, trying to convince rather than convey, and rushing the sale.
Last person.
Not being obsessed. You must like what you are doing for a living and should be obsessed with it. The most crucial words in sales today are obsession, utilization and implementation. Obsession. In order for you to be successful in sales, you must be absolutely positively obsessed with your work. You have to be dedicated to the idea that you can satisfy the customer through your product or service. Your alarm bell is in the most time to watch the clock and think of having a coffee break. And think of having a coffee break. It's not like there is no time for these things in your life. It's just that there is no time for these things in your workplace. Second is the utilization. You should utilize everything at your disposal and grow through your company brochures and catalogs. And you should have regular meetings with the sales manager to know about your performance and get new ideas from them. And you should use books and motivational tapes like this in order to put you on the right track. Implementation. Implementation is we should not take anything for granted, and we should not get bogged down with the over preparation and just do it. I know research has its own place, but you should never forget that selling is selling, and you should go to the customer and talk to him. Otherwise, your efforts are going into vain. So, how do you incorporate these three parts? Firstly, you need to make a list of what to prepare and keep your motivation up, start early and be obsessive but disciplined. The second thing is not listening to the prospect. As we all know, God gave us 2 years and 1 mouth. So we need to listen twice as much as we talk. Prospect. And you should allow him to speak everything what you want and ask the doubts about our product. And we need to give more information as much as we can. And the only thing we need to do is listen. And by listening, we give him our concentration. And concentration is very important. We need to listen whatever he's saying. Not planning the day efficiently. Firstly, we need to rank like A is equal to must do, B is equal to should do, and C is equal to do if you have them. Like we must complete our A and B by the time 2 o'clock, and we have to spare our time for C for any like crisis or anything else. And we have to prioritize our goals, leave time for crisis. And we have to get up 15 minutes early than we do now. And we need to plan our schedule the day before. Fourth mistake. Trying to convince rather than convey. If you really want to make a sale, desperately want to make a sale, then you can go into convincing method. And if you want to go with conveying methods, and you have to go with and say about the values and benefits of your product to the prospect. Sale is not about getting what you think about him. You should also see the other people's point of view also. The last one is rushing the sale. No matter what you sell or where you sell, the sale is typically broken down into four types: qualifying, interviewing, presenting, and closing. So rushing the sale, in the sense we should not go, we should not rush the sale. Like example, if we have a garden in the house and we sow the seeds of tomato seeds there, we should we need to wait for a couple of months. Like it may take the whole summer to the tomatoes to grow up. We should not rush the process, and if we rush the process, we won't get anything, and efforts will go into waste.